First of all, Oscar, how is that you come from Pune to Kopar?
Yeah, it is a long journey, and I will tell you in short. I got to see an advertisement in the local newspaper from the Ministry of Ayush, Government of India, and they wanted a professor who would visit a foreign place to teach and propagate Ayurveda there. And when I saw the specifications, I was perfectly fitting into the specifications which they wanted. So I applied for that. Then they called me to New Delhi, which is the capital of India, for an interview in the ministry. And after the interview, it was quite good surprise that they say that you were selected. But till did, at that time, I did not know for which place they were going to select me. But later on, they said that we have selected you for the post of Ayurveda chair or visiting professor to Slovenia.
Did you know anything about Slovenia before you were chosen?
No, actually, I was not aware about where Slovenia is. So when they, but I could vaguely remember that I have heard somewhere this word. But I could not remember where, in what context I have heard this. Then I went to Google and Googled Slovenia, and then I came to know that it is in Central Europe. And then I came to know that once I had read that Melania Trump, the first lady of the United States, she hails from Slovenia. And that was the reference I was aware of before.
Oh, it's good to know that.
Yeah.
And. How do you like our city and our university? You're here since March last year.
Všeč mi.
Oh, and you learned some Slovenian words.
Malo besedo.
Okay. You was teaching here in our university, but you also visit some of the other places in Slovenia, and you also teach there about Ayurveda. Where you been?
Yeah, there was, unfortunately, this year, in 2018, last year, in September, there was a conference on Ayurveda, a 3 days conference, which was arranged by the European Congress for Integrative Medicine. And luckily, I was here, so I represented my ministry, and I was the representative of our embassy. As Ayurveda chair, I was representing the University of Primorska also. So it was a 3 days conference. It was a very successful conference. Every day I had one lecture, so I had 3 lectures in this conference. So it was a great occasion, and a great occasion for Ayurveda, for its teaching and propagation. Also, other lectures I had, I was invited to the public library in Grosuple, near Ljubljana. It was also quite well attended by 25 people. And day before yesterday, I was invited to the public library in Isola. They had arranged my lecture on Ayurveda, and I'm glad to say that I was overwhelmed by the response. There were 80 people who attended my lecture. Even the library did not expect so many people.
Obviously, people in Slovenia are very interesting generally in Ayurveda, but how it's that it's reached to you, how you decide to educate it from that field?
Yeah, I would first like to thank the university, because university has given me a platform where I have my regular lectures on every Thursday at 6 p.m. in the Faculty of Humanistic Studies in the University of Primorska on the third floor. And I'm glad to tell you that I have been taking lectures since last April, almost 10 months. And I have got a very good response from the people. Almost 30 to 35 people attend my lectures every Thursday. And they are regular attendees who are regularly attending these lectures with great interest. They have so many questions to ask, so that they are keenly following Ayurveda.
How you become a doctor of Ayurveda in India? What is the path?
Yeah,
education.
Yeah. It is after you have to complete the basic 12 years of study, so you are about 18 years. at the time of 18 years, then you got to select your professional field. So either it may be engineering, medicine, law, anything. From my childhood, I was very much interested and I had this inclination towards the medical field. And I wanted to be a doctor since my childhood. That is why I chose the medical profession. Of course, the first choice of everybody is to study Western medicine in India. But I was not lucky to have that much marks to get into the Western medicine. But I could get admission into the Ayurveda course. And when I started to learn Ayurveda, then I came to know its beauty and its relevance towards our life as a human life, because Ayurveda is not only a system of medicine, but it encompasses everything regarding human life. So it may be your diet, it may be your rules regarding your sleep, your exercise, healthy living, daily routine, seasonal routine, yoga, massage, some Vedic astrology, some spirituality, some philosophy. So everything related to your human life is the knowledge of Ayurveda, and because hence it is known as the science of life, or you can say the Veda Jivalini.
Yeah. You told us you needed 12 years to become doctor of Ayurveda. Are you a doctor or are you also teaching in Pune?
After
Pune is the town where you are living.
Yeah, after 12 years of basic education, then we need to complete 6 years of basic education into becoming a doctor. So it might be any field of medicine, maybe Western medicine or maybe Ayurveda. So this is 5.5 years course, approximately 6 years. Then after this, there was an entrance exam, which is the national level entrance exam. And I applied for this national level entrance exam, and I was lucky, and due to my luck and hard work, I got into the topmost institute of India, which offers the post-graduation in Ayurveda, that is the Banaras Hindu University. There were about 1600 students who applied for this, appeared for this exam, and they select only 25 students. I was the 12th in the merit list. So I got to get admission as a study for the post-graduation course, and then I completed my MD. MD is the Doctor of Medicine. So that is the specialization in Ayurveda. So I have done my specialization in Ayurveda, and only after you do your specialization, you are eligible to become a professor in a college. So after my specialization, I applied for a professorship in the college, and I got selected there. And I started my journey as a professor, but simultaneously, I also started my own private practice as a physician. So I am both an academic person, professor teaching in the college in the daytime, and the evening time is reserved for my private practice, where I have my own private clinic set up for Ayurveda patients, and patients come to me, and then I have my own consultation. I prepare 70% of the medicines which I give to my patients. They are prepared at home.
This is different between our medicine, Western medicine, and Ayurveda medicine.
Yeah, it is completely different. Completely different. Western. Because Ayurveda medicine is mostly based on different herbs and plants. And the Western medicine is based on chemicals. So this is the basic difference there. Then we have some minerals also we use as medicines. Sometimes some metals are used, but these are processed in a particular way so that it becomes safe to have these medicines for you. So in my day-to-day practice, 70% of the medicines are prepared by ourselves at home, and we give these medicines to the patients, and then we have very good results. So I am enjoying the both phases of my life. The daytime I am in the academics, a teaching field, which is more of a theoretical, and in the evening times I am actually doing the Ayurvedic consultation and practicing Ayurveda. So it is a combination of theory and practice both.
What are you teaching in college exactly?
Yeah, my specialization is basically medicine, but I have a specialization on clinical diagnosis. So clinical diagnostics in Ayurveda is a specialized branch where you have to study the patient and the different aspects of examining the patient, able to diagnose the patient on the basis of his symptoms and basis of his examinations, and then coming to a proper conclusion, what is the chief complaint, what is the chief diagnosis, primary diagnosis, and what is the final diagnosis, and then accordingly we have to give the treatment. Because Ayurveda says that before attempting to treat, you have to diagnose the patient.
Of course. You are a professor, you have your clinic, now you are visiting a professor at our university. It's very interesting career path.
Mm-hmm.
How you think about your life? Are you satisfied with your career choice?
Yes, of course. It was not a very straight and direct path of my career. Since I took this professional course, it was mostly a curved path with ups and downs, as everybody has. But anyway, I have stick to my profession, which I have studied Ayurveda, because in India, we as Ayurvedic doctors and Ayurvedic academic study, we have to study the Western medicine also. So then after the our study, we have choice that we can practice Western medicine or we can practice Ayurveda, or you can have a mixed practice also. Most of the people who study Ayurveda, they choose Western medicine and they practice in Western medicine. But it was my conscious decision that no, I will stick to the path of practice which I have chosen to learn, and which in which I have done my specialization. And so I have stuck to my path, and I am very much satisfied. I don't have any regrets for this. And I think because of this, that I stuck to my path of teaching Ayurveda and practicing Ayurveda, I was rewarded by ministry by selecting, by seeing my resume, and then they selected me for this post, that they found me to be an apt person to be a representative from India, representative of Ayurveda, who can go abroad, go to Europe and teach and propagate Ayurveda.
If somebody of our students from our university or some other university in Slovenia would like to become Ayurveda doctor, is it possible to do so in India? Do you have foreign students?
Yeah, we don't have many foreign students, but we have some instances in the past where foreign students have been to India. One instance is from, I think he was a student from US. He came to India and he gained knowledge of Sanskrit. And then he took admission in a regular college who teaches Ayurveda. And along with the other Indian students, he completed this basic course of Ayurveda, graduate course in 5.5 years. And then he's a renowned name in the West, especially in the US. His name is Dr. Robert Svoboda. So he's a very good example to all the students who want to come over to India and learn Ayurveda and make their career in Ayurveda.
This means learning the Sanskrit is very, very important.
Yeah, not thorough Sanskrit, but at least a working knowledge of Sanskrit.
Okay, and now the last question for you.
Mm-hmm.
What is your advice to our students and to people in Koper regarding the career choice and the path that you choose to live your professional life?
Yeah, for the students, I can say this is general advice because they are students of other faculties also, but I can say that whatever your heart says, wherever your passion lies, I think you should follow that, because ultimately it does not matter whether you are an archaeologist or an architect or a doctor or an engineer or a lawyer. Your heart should be passionate about what you do, and unless and until you are passionate, you cannot find success.
Thank you, Dr. Kaas.
Thank you very much. Thank you.